What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at official Android 8.1.0 Oreo update for our MIA1. Yes, this is a beta update, but what really does matter that it's from Xiaomi, it's Android 8.1 and it's on our MIA1. Yes, although it's an Android 1 device, Xiaomi has been neglecting it all the way. Like literally, this should be receiving update as well as another flagship or as soon as the source is released for that specific Android version. Like literally, Xiaomi is making Android P betas for Mix 2S and here we have bought Android 1 device and we are still not even seeing like official Android 8.1. Well, this is a first beta with like bare bones features working and it's pretty much the same with Android 1 features because you know it's stock Android. So starting with the look, as you can see, it's pretty much the same, but there are many changes over here thanks to Android 8.1. But starting with the launcher, which is the search launcher that we get on the Android 1, there is no longer a gradient present at the bottom. There is a pixel-like tint, as you can see over here, which I'm not a huge fan of, but still we get it. On the left, you get Google Now as like standard. Also, the folder have newer animations, which are really cool. Going to the actual launcher, just basically the same. The wallpapers stay the same. There are no kind of iPhone X wallpapers which have been added to the 18x9 phones, which is kind of sad. We are still getting like wallpapers from MIUI 8 or the MIUI 7. But yeah, as this is Android 8.1, even if you like select any kind of dark image such as like this, set a wallpaper and everything would turn dark. Let's just look at this one. There you go. The launcher has been now turned dark as well as the system UI. For example, it just matches my whole MIA1, which is a matte black. And then again, there you go. System UI has been also turned black. There is also wallpaper API, which I will talk later on. But the system UI is now partially transparent, if you can see over here. Not a huge fan, but still we get it. And the folders have been now also turned black, which is not even in stock pixel launcher, I guess. But let's just go to any kind of bright wallpaper such as this one. And now if I just bring down the system UI, there you go. There is a tint over here, which is the normal wallpaper API. Now, wallpaper API can be used for various kind of applications such as for creating gradients. So, AMOLED devices don't actually get any kind of color burn-in. But then again, you can use it for many other apps such as Alarm and Color Screen if you want to build your ROM that way, but we don't get anything like that over here. You still get your normal quick settings. There is nothing been added. Going to the menu, you get stock apps such as Mi Drop, Mi File Explorer. You also get now Google Keep, which I don't think we had. And if you're wondering why there are two camera apps, well, as this is like the first alpha betas for the Android 8.1, I seriously don't know how Xiaomi just messed it up, but the stock camera app is not actually working. As you can see, it just crashes. It's not actually lib fault, but the camera APK is just not working. So you can actually enable camera API too and install any kind of Google camera such as this Pixel 3 one. Works just great, no issues at all. So camera is currently broken. Also, some of the guys are telling that Volte is not working. Also, 5 GHz Wi-Fi is broken. So that's also the bugs which have been noticed right now. Again, nothing in apps. So let's just hop over to the settings. And if you notice, we are not getting any kind of pixel-like theming like blue, which I thought we would be getting. But now, as you can see, it's teal rather than blue. You can finish your setup just like this. It shows a Pixel 2 OE, which is weird. No thanks. Never. In features, nothing has been changed, but there is actually an introduction to a new feature called accelerated location. It actually needs your consent in order to improve your location performance and battery saving. I know it's a bit weird, but it is a new addition and the sound is much more sharper than before, which is a very nice addition. Going to the battery. The battery is much more looking like now a cylinder. That's the only update over here. Going to the display, advanced. All the features are still the same, but the ambient display gets a bit of a UI update to match it like the Android 1 scheme. Then the screen saver gets a bit of an update for current screen saver. You can set it for clock or just never. You get your normal MI services over here. Going to the system, you get all sorts of features just like before, like system UI tuner gestures, which can be enabled. Going to the system update, latest and the greatest, Android 8.1. And the security patch is May 5, yes. Xiaomi is actually cheating on security patches. Most of you guys told me that OEMs get it before. No, Google actually pushes out the next month, almost like the last week. And yes, it is April 30 today, but May 5 security patch is not actually happening as if right now. You can actually check it on the Google server. So yeah, Xiaomi is actually cheating on that part. But build number, as you can see, 8.4.28. So this build is 2 days old, Android version 8.1.0. And speaking of Android 8.1, treble support. Nope. Xiaomi is not giving us that. They gave it for the Mi Mix 2, then again they even gave it for the Redmi Note 5 Pro. Redmi Note 5 doesn't get it, as well as the MIA1. No Snapdragon 625 phones have actually the treble support, officially. Of course, Redmi Note 5 and Note 4 have unofficial support, but we have to still wait it for the MIA1. And that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching. This is your new power menu. As you can see, the wallpaper API turning on. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you want more MI1 videos like this, please let me know in the comment section below. And if you want to install it on your own risk, zip will be down there. You can also install it with the fastboot. And see you in the next one. Peace.